Beyond Breast Cancer on BCTV is supported by the Berks County Medical Society Alliance Incorporated.
Hello and welcome to Beyond Breast Cancer. My name is Michele Reinert and I'm the Executive Director for Breast Cancer Support Services of Berks County. We are a survivor-driven organization that provides hope, emotional support, education, and resources to every person affected by breast cancer. We are here today to talk about our upcoming community events, special events and fundraisers, and the ways that you can volunteer at and support the organization. I am joined in studio today. To my right, we have Madisyn Klein, our marketing and special events coordinator. And to my left, we have Leslie Fessler, our ambassador and volunteer coordinator. Ladies, thank you for joining me today. Mm-hmm. So Leslie, I'm gonna throw it over to you to start with our community events.
Okay, we are many times invited to have different tabling events at various locations, and we go there to obviously tell our mission for what we are all about. So first off, we have on April 21st, the Junior League of Reading Touch a Truck, which will be from 9:30 to 3 p.m. at the First Energy Stadium. And then we also have May 4th, Humane PA Walk for Animals, which will be held Saturday, May 4th from 10 to 2 at the Berks County Fairgrounds. And then on May 11th, we have the health fair in collaboration with NAACP Representative Johanny Freitas, and that will be at the Zion Baptist Church.
Yeah, so it's kind of just the beginning of the season for us. We from like in April and then early May, it really kind of takes off. But we do get invited to a lot of these community events, and it's wonderful to just be able to kind of set up a table, hand out some program brochures, some marketing materials, but really share our mission, who we are and what we do, and kind of also tell our story to the local community. We often find that there are several people who will stop by the table who will say like, wow, we had no idea there was an organization like this. And then in addition to that, we'll also have the same number of people stop by and let us know that they are a survivor and at some point in time they did come to the organization and attend some programs. So it's just a great way for us to be out and about in the community that we serve and just kind of tell them a little bit more about who we are and what we do. But I think more importantly too, kind of how we've grown and evolved since the pandemic and the changes that have been made to the programs that we offer. So Maddie, do you want to talk a little bit about the tabling events?
Of course, yeah. You can find us at two tabling events in West Reading this year. On Saturday, June 15th from 11 to 7 p.m., we will be at Arts on the Avenue. And then we will also be at the West Reading Fall Fest on Saturday, September 21st from 11 a.m. to 7 p.m., excuse me. If you follow us on social media, we'll always post something about where our table will be found at those two events, and you can always come visit us, say hi, or if you're interested in volunteering, you can always contact Leslie Fessler, our volunteer coordinator.
Yeah, so we tend to, on the all-day events, kind of break it out into shifts, and then we have volunteers that will attend with staff, seasoned volunteers, and board members to cover those events. The West Reading ones are great because it's kind of right in the backyard. We're right off of Reading Avenue when you come into the West Reading area. And you will have, you know, thousands of people that will attend that event throughout the day. So again, it's a great way just to support the community where we are and then also be visible and be seen, be able to answer some questions, have a little fun and do some chatting. And I think most of the volunteers that sign up tend to walk the event before and after their scheduled shift. So those are a lot of fun to be at as well. And then leading into some of the special events and fundraisers that we do at the organization, we are thrilled. This year will be our 9th annual Pink Passion for Fashion show. This, for the last few years, had been held in October in recognition of Breast Cancer Awareness Month. And we learned over the last few years how much happens from, you know, mid-September to mid-November, the kind of leading up to and then after wrapping up Breast Cancer Awareness Month. So our goal was to move this back into the spring so that this would actually kick off the fundraising event season for us. So in order to do that, we are hosting the event Sunday, August 11th this year. And again, it will be at the Doubletree here in downtown Reading. And then in 2025, for our 10-year anniversary, we'll host the event in May. So it'll be May 18th of 2025, and then we'll continue in May moving forward. But this is a fabulous event, and I think the most important thing to mention is that all of the models are local breast cancer survivors. We can have anywhere from 12 to 16 survivors that are actually modeling and, you know, kind of strutting their stuff on the runway. And then the secondary part is our survivors also nominate their favorite healthcare workers. And this could be a social worker, an oncologist, a nurse, navigator. It might even be the person who's taking care of your chemo or radiation while you're at the hospital. But the survivors actually nominate those folks, and they're referred to as our shining stars. So those are the individuals in the medical field that have made a positive difference to local survivors. They actually nominate them, and then we typically have four or six medical professionals that join our survivors on the stage. This event has grown considerably since 2021. We were super thrilled. We added seats last year. We went from 300 to 350 and sold the event out again. So this year we're actually increasing the seats to 400 and hoping that we sell out again. So last year we raised over $64,000, and all of the proceeds from our special event fundraisers go right back into programming. I think it's important to mention that every program, resource, anything that we provide is done at no cost to the survivor, their family members, and their caregivers. So we're essentially raising 100% of our operating budget every year. So it's really important that these events do well and that they sell out. We are doing about $425,000 a year right now is our budget, which has more than doubled since 2019. So we're happy to be able to provide the additional services, things that go beyond just your diagnosis, and also now be able to include family members in the things that we do. So if you're interested in attending, the tickets are already on sale. You can visit our website, bcssberks.org. You can go ahead and purchase your tickets and reserve your spot today. In addition to that, we are also looking for sponsors and in-kind donations. The in-kind donations are used for the silent auction at the event. That's always interesting. It gets very competitive, a lot of bidding going on there. We also do a fund-in-need drive, which is our live auction at the event. And again, that's monies raised that go right back into programming. So if you're interested or you have any questions, you can give the office a call, 610-478-1447. Visit the website at bcssberks.org. And whoever picks up the phone can certainly answer your questions and help you out. If you have anything in regards specifically to sponsorships and in-kind donations, feel free to reach out to myself or Maddie. We'd be happy to talk to you about those things. The second event that we would like to talk about is our 10th annual Hear Our Voices Team Holly 5K. So this September 8th, it's a Sunday, we will host again over at Gringsmill Recreation Area. This, I'm so thrilled, like this is our 10th year, and it's something, again, this is another event that has grown over the last few years. It's also an event that's very near and dear to all of our hearts because it was actually founded and started by Holly Lamont. She was a survivor who was looking for a way to not only make a difference and raise some funds for BCSS, but also to make sure that patient and survivors' voices were heard. So that's what led us to, in 2014, the first annual Hear Our Voices 5K. Unfortunately, Holly was not with us in 2015 for the second event, and that is when we changed it to Hear Our Voices Team Holly. And we do this in memory of Holly every year, and also to keep her legacy alive, as this was very important to her. We have her husband, children, and family members involved. So we are hoping to see about 400 people in attendance this year. We were over 300 last year. We raised over $28,000. And again, registration is currently open. We do partner with Pretzel City Sports, so you can visit their website to register online. You can also visit our website for additional information. Sponsorship and donor opportunities are available for this event as well. And then, Maddie, I'm going to have you talk a little bit about the teams that are fairly new but really took off last year for the event.
Yeah, of course. So last year, as Michele mentioned, we had teams, and that really became popular. Whether if you are have a big group of friends or if you work in an office, it doesn't matter. Teams can be as little as two people or they can be as big as many people as you would like to join. You can always contact me or call the office for more information. But it's really simple. You can create a team if you want to have a team name. We get a website up and running for you. It's like a fundraising page, so you can copy and paste a link on your social media, send it out to your friends, and people can go onto that webpage and directly donate to BCSS and help support the 5K this year. Yep. So yeah, if you have, like I said, any questions, feel free to call the office or reach out. Yeah.
Yep. I think it's kind of cool because Maddie will set the page up for you for your team. You can have as many people join that page as you would like. Or if you have one of those overachievers, they can set up their own page through that, right, as well.
Yep,
so I want to say that last year we had probably six teams total, which was more than we had had previously. And one of those teams just blew everybody out of the water, raising over $2,000. So it's kind of become a little bit of a competitive thing. And again, as Maddie said, as small or as large as you would like, our very first team ever, it's only two people and they've been with us 3 years now since the team started, is the two good-hearted grandmas. And every year their page is the first one up and they get that out there and they share that and they do a really nice job. So at any rate, it's also nice too, like if for some reason you can't be at the event, but you still want to support it and raise some funds and share that awareness with everybody, that's a way you can do it as well. So again, feel free to reach out if you'd like to get that started. You can open your team page up at any time. We could set that up as soon as today. So very much looking forward to seeing what kind of friendly competition we can get going to grow that some more this year.
And then also coming up on Saturday, September 14th from 2 p.m. to 6 p.m., we have a breast cancer awareness color run.
Yeah, so that is something that we did 2 years ago with Paul at Nemesis Fitness. We did a breast cancer awareness run during the month of October. Mother Nature did not necessarily cooperate for that event, but the turnout was great. We had a lot of fun, had a good time. We did not do this last year, and then we talked about this year doing it in a different time frame so it wouldn't be in the middle of Breast Cancer Awareness Month. So Paul graciously agreed to kind of switch that date around a little bit, which is why we now have the September 14th date. So there will be more information coming out about that soon. But if you've been to any of his other color runs or the glow stick run, they are a ton of fun. Hundreds of people turn out, and it's just a great afternoon and a wonderful way to support folks with breast cancer. The patients, the fighters, the thrivers, the survivors all across the board, they all come out and support the event as well. So it's definitely a family-friendly event. We had I think the kids might have outnumbered the adults, not sure. But again, Saturday, September 14th, so look for more details coming soon.
Okay, and then we also have coming up our third annual trap shoot at the South End Gun Club over on 5330 Lorraine Road in Reading, PA. This is going to take place on Saturday, November 10th, and this is just a really fun event to be outside if you're really into trap shooting and everything. We also have the silent auction.
Yeah, so we have a silent auction, and they do raffles throughout the course of the day, too. So, yeah, you can get a team signed up, and again, all of those proceeds come back to BCSS. In addition to that, the ticket price, so you'll get a team of five, and you can decide the number of clay pigeons that you'd like to purchase when you get there. There's also a meal provided for participants. I think we got the most feedback about that last year. Mm-hmm. Well, first, the weather was great. So it was a gorgeous day. So everybody had a lot of fun. But they also got a steak dinner at lunchtime, mm-hmm. which they were super happy about. So we're going to do that again this year, in addition to providing some breakfast items and refreshments throughout the day. That one's also a lot of fun. And that kind of wraps up our fundraising season. It's our final one of the year. So we're thrilled to be partnering with South End Gun Club to do that again this year. And then, Leslie, I'm going to let you talk about the next one because you kind of got this whole thing started for us.
Yeah. So on Saturday, November 2nd, we are going to have the fourth annual Cow Pie Bingo held at the Straustown Rod and Gun. So this has become a pretty nice size event. Mm-hmm. Last year, we made $15,000 off of that one. Mm-hmm. So it's a pretty neat event. If you've never been to a cow pie bingo, you surely want to come out. And we do they do a lot of raffles and all sorts of things that contribute to the bingo that day. Yeah, I just really enjoy it. Started out, I just talked to one of the people there and they suggested that we start something like this, and wow, it took off right from the beginning.
And it's so funny how like it just grows year after year. Because mm-hmm. like the first year it was like the one day event, but the club and their members just did such a phenomenal job of internally like selling the pink ribbons, selling the pink drinks. I want to say there was like, I went upwards of like 100 raffle baskets,
right. Oh, yeah.
Which they continue to do. Mm-hmm. And those things kind of started in September and went through October. And then when we got to year two, it was like, well, what can we do to make this a little bit bigger, a little bit better? So like we added a second week with like an entertainment mm-hmm. and some other things.
Yeah, last so it's week, been a...
It was three weekends last year.
It was three
year.
Weekends in a row, yeah. So every year they're trying to add a little something different. So stay tuned. We'll be posting what other events may be going on sometime in the end of October, beginning of November there, of what they will be having going on.
Yeah, and it's kind of cool because in order to come to those events, you don't have to be a member, mm-mm. and it is family friendly. I know what last year was kind of like their own sort of touch a truck mm-hmm. event. The year before that, we had entertainment. I think this year there's been some talk about potentially having something going on every weekend in October mm-hmm. leading up to the big event in November then. Mm-hmm. So it's a ton of fun, always a good time, great group of people. And again, Leslie's right. If you've never been to a cow pie bingo, it's interesting and it's something.
It is.
And it can take a while or not so much.
So again, that is at the Straustown Rod and Gun Club, and that's 81 Club Road, Straustown, Pennsylvania, 19559. Hope to see you all there.
All right, so with that, we're going to kind of shift gears now into volunteering and all those opportunities.
Okay, we have different events that we need volunteers for. A lot of our events, so we're taking just a few volunteers mm-hmm. per, like, tabling event, two to three. Mm-hmm. So it's not like we need 20 people at one time, but...
But only for the 5K and the fashion show.
That's where we need, like, a lot of help. Mm-hmm. So we have a speakers bureau, community awareness, finance, and fund development committee, survivor volunteers for the support line, and contact a survivor. So if you'd be interested in any of those, please contact the office at 610-478-1447, and we'd be happy to get you set up to help us.
Yeah. So I think like with the Speakers Bureau, and that kind of goes both ways, because that is looking for individuals that are close to the organization, and actually there are times when we can be asked to be multiple places at one time, particularly in September and October. We get asked to come to many different things several days a week. So it can be going out to a community event and speaking on behalf of the organization. That'll sometimes happen with like Leo clubs and Rotary clubs and things like that. In addition to that, it can also be utilizing your network of individuals to actually become speakers for the organization to come in and present on different topics and things like that. the committees that we're looking for volunteers for, most of those committees meet either monthly or bi-monthly, and it's really based on your preference of what you feel your skill sets are, how you'd like to get involved. Community awareness looks more at getting us out into the community to those tabling events, putting program brochures and organizational brochures in. Last year they did public libraries, doctor's offices, things like that. This year they're working on lists for the local churches to make sure that all the parishioners understand the programs and resources that are available to them as Berks County residents. The survivors for the support line and contact a survivor, I think it is important to mention that you do need to be 1 year out from your diagnosis, and there is extra, I don't want to steal Maddie's thunder, but there's additional training for that. Right now we have about 12 individuals mm-hmm. on the support line for calling in, probably 6 to 8 on the email a survivor. We're definitely looking to increase both of those numbers. And that essentially would mean that you may get an email from someone who is newly diagnosed or having a recurrence, or they just finished chemo and radiation, and now what? They're just looking for somebody who's kind of walked that journey and is able to help them and support them and kind of tell them what to expect next. Almost kind of like a buddy system. So I'm going to ask you to talk a little bit more about the ambassadors, since that is your passion.
Okay. Yeah, we just recently opened up, I'm the ambassador coordinator, so we, Emily and I had wrote the whole program, and now I actually go with patients who have no one to go with them to doctor's appointments. I find it very beneficial because when I was going through chemo, to see people there with not having anyone with them was kind of disheartening. So I had a passion to want to be able to do that, and I am currently doing that, and some days it's a little hard doing it mm-hmm. because, you know, just the not knowing for myself, but I really enjoy doing that. So if you know anybody that's going through breast cancer that would like a buddy to go with, I'd be more than happy to do that.
Mm-hmm. And I think too, in mentioning that the curriculum that Leslie and Emily wrote specific to that group, because there are the first class of 3 survivors mm-hmm. have been trained. So if the need is greater than Leslie is able to be there for and be present, we have 3 other individual survivors who have also went through the training and are able to attend those appointments with you. So Leslie is currently working with someone who she meets on a weekly basis, whether it's a doctor appointment, to have blood work drawn, to sit with them through chemo, whatever that looks like. Anything in relation to that diagnosis that's with a doctor or even a dentist appointment, because mm-hmm. depending on what your treatment plan is, there can be oral issues that come mm-hmm. with that. So I just think it's great that you have that ability to have someone meet you there and be with you mm-hmm. and not only support you in that emotional way, but also to help ask questions. All of the things that maybe you wish you would have known mm-hmm. to ask, you now have this person who can help format those questions and ask them for you, which I think is great. So. In that breath, Maddie, I'm going to turn it over to you to talk a little bit more about volunteer training.
Of course, yeah. If you're interested in volunteering with us, we have 2 upcoming trainings. We have one on Tuesday, May 21st. This is at the BCSS office, or if you can't come into the office, it will be offered on Zoom. This will be from 2 p.m. to 3 p.m. And then if you're not able to make that date, we also have another one on Wednesday, May 22nd. This is Zoom only from 6 p.m. to 7 p.m. And this will always be done by a BCSS staff member. Mm-hmm. And they're pretty short, only like 30 minutes to an hour. And we also offer, if you are a survivor and interested in the support line or a contact survivor, we also have that option at the very end of the basic training that we have.
Yeah, so we do kind of ask everybody, no matter what your interest is, and we do have volunteer opportunities mm-hmm. for everybody. We have some folks that only come in, you know, 3 times a year to help stuff comfort bags. We have volunteers who only come in 2 a year to assist with mailings. We have a much larger group that like to do the tabling events. So Leslie will send out 2 a month an email that says, here's what's coming up, here's what we're looking for help with. We do ask that everybody that volunteers for us does attend one of the trainings. And it's really just to share with you what to expect, frequently asked questions, helpful information. And then that additional half an hour is in regards to if you want to be on the phone line or the support line, really to help prepare you, because there's also some self-awareness and mm-hmm. self-care that you really need to be cognizant of and kind of take care of when you're helping other people going through something that you've already went through. It can drum up, I think you could speak yeah. to that, right? Emotions and things that you've been through. So the most important thing is to take care of you in order to help take care of other people. Mm-hmm. But there are a multitude of volunteer opportunities. There is an application on our website, again, bcssberks.org. You can also call the office, 610-478-1447, or you can reach out to Leslie directly. Once that volunteer application, which you can fill out right online, comes into the office, Leslie will reach out to you, confirm that we received it, ask mm-hmm. some questions, work on getting you scheduled for a volunteering. And we never send anybody out blindly to do anything. You will always be with the staff or board member or a seasoned volunteer the first couple times that you go out. And again, if you're interested in helping with special events, we do recruit about 20 to 25 volunteers to help with the 5K and about 30 volunteers to help with the fashion show. So if you're interested in an event and you'd like to help out, we would definitely appreciate your help. You can go about that way. And in addition to that, a couple easy ways that you can support BCSS or donate. There is a donate now on our website, bcssberks.org. You can also do something as simple as a birthday fundraiser on Facebook. We have a lot of those done. We also do a lot of third-party fundraisers, so you could host your own fundraiser for BCSS. We have some people who it could be as simple as, hey, you can wear jeans every Friday in August for $1, and then that money gets donated to BCSS. It could be that you're actually going to do some kind of little event on your own. Adelphia Seafood does a great one every year, and then we show up as staff and set up a table, hand out information, and ask questions. Tons of different ways. You can even just send a text, BCSS, to 44321. But again, we do raise 100% of our budget every year. We will see 300 women diagnosed in Berks County every year. We'll hear those words, you have breast cancer. It can be anywhere from 0 to 5 men because they get it as well. So we would just like to thank the community for your continued support that allows us to keep our doors open and do what we do in supporting local patients, survivors, thrivers, mm-hmm. the whole nine yards, and now additionally, you know, their family members and caregivers. So thank you so much. We'll see you next time.
Beyond Breast Cancer on BCTV is supported by the Berks County Medical Society Alliance Incorporated.